In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome to episode 15 of the whole Bible series, where we study the Bible from the book of Genesis till the book of Revelation. Today, we're going to start with the book of Exodus. We're going to cover the first 7 chapters. So let's get started. Exodus chapter 1 till chapter 7. Of course, the most famous character in the book of Exodus is Prophet Moses, whom God chose to lead his people out of Egypt. This map illustrates the path of the Jewish people from the land of Egypt through Sinai into the Promised Land. This trip took him 40 years and is covered in 3 books: the book of Exodus, the book of Leviticus, and the book of Numbers. Before we start talking about the book of Exodus, let's review some facts. First, the number of the Jewish people who came to Egypt were 70 persons. However, the number of the Jewish who left Egypt were 600,000 men, without children and women. So total, it add up almost to 2 million people. The Jewish people lived 430 years in Egypt. So in 430 years, they multiplied and grew from 70 persons to 2 million people. Joseph came to Egypt during the time of Hyksos era, between 1630 to 1523 before Christ. The Hyksos were not Egyptian pharaohs. They were foreign kings or shepherd kings. They came to Egypt around 1630 and occupied till 1523. This drawing from the temple of Egypt illustrates the time of the Hyksos era. They ruled Egypt around 150 or 160 years. They were famous for their military chariot. This map of Egypt at that time were basically show you the Jewish people dwelled in this area, which was rich and fertile for their sheep. The Hyksos stayed in Egypt until 2 Egyptian pharaohs conquered them, Chemos and Ahmos. They conquered the Hyksos and kick him away out from Egypt. Then new Egyptian pharaohs came and start persecuting the Jewish people in many ways. They make him slave by brick and mortar. They force him to build 2 cities, Pithom and Ramses. Then when the Jewish people grow so many, pharaoh start to order the midwife to kill the boys. However, the midwives fear God more than pharaoh, and they didn't listen to him. And God blessed them and built home as a reward for them. Then Pharaoh got mad and ordered his people to cast all the Jewish boy into the Nile. But as it was mentioned in the Exodus chapter 1, verse 12, that God's blessing was with them. But the more they were oppressed, the more they multiplied and spread. So the Egyptian came to dread the Israelite. When Moses was born, his mom hid him at home for 3 months. After 3 months, she put him in a basket and put him at the river banks. And Miriam, his older sister, was watching over him. Through God's plan, Pharaoh's daughter, who was barren at this time, she found Moses, and she was so happy to find this little cute boy. Miriam, his sister, told her, "I can go and get you one of the Hebrew mom to nurse this baby." So she took Moses to his mom and she nursed him until he grew and brought him back to the palace of Pharaoh. And Moses lived for 40 years as a prince in Pharaoh's palace. He learned all the military technique. He learned all the military method of fighting. And at age of 40, he went out to visit his Jewish people. And by chance, he found one of the Egyptian master beating one of the Jewish. So he got angry and hit the Egyptian master and killed him and buried him. The next day actually carried a surprise to Moses when he found 2 Jewish people fighting between one another, and Moses tried to intervene. One of the men told him, "Who made you judge or prince over us? Are you intent to kill me as you did with the Egyptian man yesterday?" So Moses realized that his story became known, and he understood that Pharaoh would look for him to kill him as a punishment for killing the Egyptian man. So Moses got scared and ran away to the desert of Sinai. And he sailed by a well. And it happened at this time that Reuel, the Midianite, has 7 daughters. They came with their sheep to feed their sheep. The shepherd blocked their way. So Moses intervened, helped them. And Reuel, the Midianite, invited him to his home and stayed with him. And he married one of his daughters. Her name is Zipporah. And he got a son. And he gave him a very interesting name, Gershom, which means stranger in a foreign land. The same way Joseph called his first son Manasseh, saying that God made me forget all my suffering. Now Moses named his first son Gershom because it reflects his status, stranger in a foreign land. And Moses spent 40 years with Reuel taking care of his sheep. He stayed 40 years as a shepherd man until he became 8 years old. God called him through a very stunning view, a burning bush. So Moses started to come closer to understand why this bush is burning, but it's not dried and dead yet. And God called him, "Moses, Moses." So he said, "Here I am." Then God told him, "Do not come near. Take your sandals off your feet, for the place on which you are standing is a holy ground." And God started to speak to Moses in details and explain to him his plan to deliver the Jewish people out of Egypt. He told him, "I have surely seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cry because of their taskmaster. I know their suffering, and I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptian." But Moses started to make excuses, and he told God, "Who I am that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the children of Israel out of Egypt?" So God assured him and gave him a sign. "This shall be the sign for you that I have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God on this mountain." Exodus chapter 3, verse 12. Then Moses started to come with a list of excuses. He said, "First, they're going to ask me, who is this God and what's his name?" And God told him, "You should tell him, I am who I am. That's my name." But Moses came back and said, "Okay, they will not believe me or listen to me. Okay, God, I'll give you some sign to prove that I sent you." Then Moses started to come with the third excuse, saying, "I am stutter my speech. I'm slow with speech, slow of tongue. I'm not eloquent, neither before nor since have you spoken to your servant." But God started to give Moses 3 important signs. First, he told him, "Look at the rod in your hand, throw it in the ground, and it turned into a snake, a true snake." Moses was scared, but God told him, "Don't be afraid, hold the snake by its tail." And Moses did, and it turned back to be a rod. In the second sign, God told him, "Put your hand in your bosom and bring it out. It turned to be very white like snow." Then ask him to put it back in his chest, and it turned back as a normal flesh. And God told him, "If you don't listen to these 2 signs, take some of the Nile water and pour it on the dry land, and it will turn into blood." And Aaron went down to meet Moses, and Moses told him about God's message and told him what exactly you should say when you see Pharaoh for the first time. "Let my son go, that they may serve me. If they refuse to let him go, behold, I will kill your firstborn son." So the plan to kill the firstborn son of Pharaoh was already declared from the beginning to Moses in Exodus chapter 4. These are the 3 signs that God gave to Moses: the rod that turned into snake, the hand that turned into white as snow, and the Nile water that will turn into blood. Moses and Aaron met together, and God told them, "I will be with your mouth and teach you what you shall say." Moses and Aaron went to their Jewish people, explained to them God's plan and how they're going to be delivered out from the land of slavery into a promised land into a land that rich in beautiful fruits like honey and milk. The first encounter with Pharaoh when Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh's palace and told him, God gave you this message. Let my people go that they may hold a feast to me in the wilderness. But Pharaoh refused and said, who is the Lord that should obey his voice to let Israel go? I don't know the Lord, nor I will listen to Israel, or I will let Israel go. And furthermore, he said to them, Moses and Aaron, why do you take the people from their work? Get back to your labor. And start a second wave of persecution. So Pharaoh ordered the taskmaster, you shall not more give the people straw to make bricks as before. Let them go and gather straw for themselves. But the tail of the bricks should remain the same. So the Jewish people got mad at Moses and Aaron and told him, may the Lord look on you and judge you. You have made us obnoxious to Pharaoh and his official and have put a sword in their hand to kill us. So Moses, as a good servant, went back to God and complained to him. He said, why, Lord, have you brought trouble on these people? Is this why you have sent me? But God assured Moses and renewed his promise of salvation. He told him, I am the Lord. I appeared to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob as God Almighty. But by my name, the Lord, I did not make myself fully known to them. So Moses reported this to the Israelites, but did not listen or heed to him because of the anguish of the spirit and for the cruel bondage. And Moses went back to God and complained again, saying, the children of Israel have not heeded me. How then shall Pharaoh heed me? For I am of uncircumcised lip. But the Lord assured him and said, I am the Lord, speak to Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, all I say to you. And see here, Moses started to grow in a trust of God, started being more obedient than before. He started to put all the things in God's hand and let God start the ship. So Moses went back again with Aaron to meet Pharaoh at his palace. And they renew the order, let my people go so they serve me. And Pharaoh starts asking for a sign. And here comes the first sign. Moses throw the Aaron rods and it turned into a snake. And Pharaoh looked to his magician and asked him if he can make something similar. So all the magicians and sorcerers did the same. They threw the rods and turned into a snake. But behold, Aaron rod became stronger and ate all the other snakes. However, Pharaoh was hardened in heart, didn't listen to Moses and Aaron, and refused to let the people go. And that will take us to the 10 plagues, which we're going to start discussing in the next talk. Thank you for attending, and I see you next week when we start discussing the 10 plagues.